Hello everyone, this is Udito from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to show you what are the different techniques to use translation in your Salesforce flow. So without any further delay, let's jump into a Salesforce or create a Salesforce flow and use translation within that Salesforce flow. So here I am in my Salesforce org. So let's start by building a screen flow. So I'll click on new flow here and start from scratch. And let's put a screen flow. In the screen flow, let's add a screen element. Give them the name as welcome. Here, let's put a display text. And here, welcome message. And here in the welcome message, if I type my welcome message here, welcome to Technical Potpourri. So if I put a message like that, then what will happen if I have a user whose language is not English, for example, say French, that French person, when that person will run the flow, he will also see the message in English. But that's not what we want. We want the message to be translated in the user's local language. So what we can do, we can create a label and use that label inside the flow. So for that, let's go to the Salesforce org and let's create a label. I think I've already created a label for this. Welcome, that's the label. And it's a welcome to Technical Potpourri, and this is a corresponding French translation. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this label inside my message here. So for that, let's get rid of that. And here, type label, and then choose this one, welcome. And click on done, save. Let's give a name as translation flow, save, activate. Now let's put the flow in the home page. So for that, edit the page and choose the flow from here and put it at the top. And here choose the flow that we have created just now, which is translation flow, save. And done. Now, when this is me, my local is English. So when I'm running this flow, the message is coming in English. I have another user. This is the user whose name is Jonathan. And when Jonathan is a French user, when Jonathan will run the flow, Jonathan is seeing the message. And what is this? Let's get rid of that. Let's refresh again. Looks good. So when Jonathan will go to the same page, the home page, the message is coming in the French language. So this is one way how you can use custom label to translate the messages within your flow. Okay, now let's put something more into that flow. Let's say here we'll put a text element, and the text element label is, let's say, enter your full name. And let's done. Save as, save, activate. And now let's go back to the home page and refresh. Looks good, enter your full name. Let's bring the French user, refresh. This is not correct. This should also be in French. So how we can do that? So the way to do that is you need to go to the translation workbench. Translation workbench and go to translate. Now here you need to choose language as French. From the setup component, select flow. It's a screen flow. And the name of the flow is translation flow. The flow component, we are looking for screen component. And the flow version 2. And enter your full name and the field level. That's what we are looking for. So we need to translate this. So for that, I will rely on Google Translation. Enter your full name. This is a corresponding translation in French. So I'll copy that. And I'll put that here. Save. Now if I bring back my French user and do a refresh, it's coming in French. Whereas if I continue with my English user, which is me, it's still in English. So this is one way how you can translate your field level, your screen component level, you can translate to your whatever language that you want. That's good. Okay, let's say here I have help text. Help text again, here you can use the label to do the translation. If I use a label, you can use the label, and inside the label, I can put the translation. That's a good thing. What about validate input? Validate input is basically, let's say if someone is trying to go to the next page without writing something in the full name, what will happen? We want to show them some error message. So if I mark this as required, save as, save, and then activate. Now here, if I try to finish, it is telling me, please enter some valid input. What will happen if I do the same thing for the French user? It's telling the language, it's telling the error message in the French. But the problem here is that this message is automatically coming from Salesforce. If I want to put my own message, my own error message, how can I do that? So the way to do that is basically open the flow, and in the flow, here you need to put your criteria, what you want to check. Definitely the thing that you want to check, if there is anything inside this box or not. So basically what I want to do, I want to validate if there is something inside this full name field or not. Definitely a full name cannot be one character. It has to be more than one character. So what I am doing here is basically, I am checking the length of this resource, which is basically enter full name. So I'm going to check the length of this resource. And if it is greater than one, means it's correct. It means I'm assuming that there is something inside the full name. Otherwise, if it is not greater than one, then what I am trying to do, I'm trying to put up my own error message. So my own error message is, you cannot continue without providing your full name. So again, let's validate again. So I'm checking the length. If the length is greater than one, then it's good. If the length is not greater than one, then this is a message I want to print inside my, just next to this component, next to the screen element. So let's click on done, save as, save, activate, and let's run the flow again. If I put just one character and try to click on finish, I'm getting a message which is my custom message. You cannot continue without providing your full name. Let's try to do the same thing for my French user. Let's bring the French user again here. Put a single character and try to do that again. It's working, but the error message is coming in English. So we need to change that. So how can we change that? There's two ways. One way is definitely here. In the validate input, here you can use a label, and inside the label you can provide the French translation. Or another option is like here, if you go to the translate workbench, select French because that's the language you want to change. Select flow. It's a screen flow. Select the flow, which is basically translate flow. Then you want to put a screen component. Yes. Version, choose the latest version. And enter your full name, yes, and here is the error message. So this is your error message, so you need to translate and put the translation here. So for that, let me copy this, put it into my friend Google Translate, and let's copy that and bring it back to my translation workbench. Save. Now if I bring back my French user and try to do the same thing, the message that I'm getting now in French. So this is another way how you can translate your error message inside your flow to multiple languages. Okay, so another thing that which I want to show you is that let's add one more screen element here. And let's add the screen element as end. And let's put a message like display text here, end message. And here again, use the label, custom label. Let's use end, save. What is the translation of end? It's fin. So I'll put new here and language French, I'll put fin, done. So now I want to use this label inside my flow. So what I'll do is that label is not coming. So let's choose that and replace this with this and done. So that's my flow looks like. So let's save that, activate, and let's quickly test. So now if I put something, go to next, it's telling level.end, which is not correct because I believe is end, right? Yeah. So what I need to do, I need to do a refresh. Come here. Here I need to put, let's get rid of that. Level end. Now it should be good. Activate. Okay, now let's refresh this page again. Perfect, it looks good. So now, what about all these buttons, right? Next button, previous button, finish button. If I want to put my own message, if the text of the button is my own, right? How can I do that? So for here, let's configure the footer. So we have the next button. Let's say I want to put my own message, which is basically go to next page. Previous button, this is the first page, so there is no previous button. Pause button, let's put hold on. Let's do that. On the next screen, let's say we have a finish button. Let's put end. Here, previous button, go back. Pause button, hold on. And done. Now save the flow, activate. And let's see again. You can see here, this is a custom message I'm getting. So now if I go back here, this is another custom message. This is another custom message. Same, if I open my French user here, this is the problem. It's coming, the button text is coming in English, but this is a French user, so it should be in French. So how can I do that? So there are two ways to do that. One way is definitely here, use the label. And then inside the label, use your translation. Second option is basically go to the translation workbench again. Same thing, language as French, flow, from the object screen flow. Here choose translation flow. Here you choose the screen info. I believe that's the screen info. Choose the version. So first is basically pause my next finish button. So you have end. So end means in French is basically fin. So put fin. Go to next page. It's basically this. So let's copy that, put it here. Save, back button, go back. Let's put that in here again. So it means this. So I'll put it here. Pause button, hold on. Means this. So I'll copy that, put it here, save. And now, if I bring back my French user, is not anymore in English. It's corresponding the French language that I'm getting. And here, again, this is in French, this is in French. But if I open the same one in as me, where I am the English user, I'm getting the English language. So this is a very quick video where I'm showing you how easily you can use translation inside your flow. You don't need to write any custom LW or a component. Basically, Flow is quite flexible enough to handle all sort of translation inside your flow. So I hope you like this video. You are able to learn something from this video. If you like this video, please share with your friends, with your colleagues, and please subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.